We begin the current daf Masechtas Baba Kama daf Lamed. We begin on the second line down at the top of the Yamad. We continue the halacha, the next Mishnah, continuing the theme of these previous Mishnayos, as the title of the parak is Hamaniach, which Hamaniach was if you're putting a jug in the street, some of those trips. What's the halacha regarding liability for things that you're doing in the street? Our Mishnah continues on that theme, discussing the Rishus Harabim and regarding the liability of damages. Rishus corresponds with Kazakh and the Cheskel turned to Bevachayim. Throughout the entire world. Some discussing today's daf are the first mission we're going to discuss. Talks about Hashreitach Mayim Brishus Rab. Someone pours water in the street. Behuzik Behen Acher. Someone else gets injured. So the Mishnah tells us Chayiv Beniskoy. So the person who spilled the water is going to be liable for the damages. Now Rab is going to qualify in the Gemara and he's going to say, wait, Loishan, we didn't learn this, and we actually mentioned this already on the Chav Chesem and Aleph, this qualification of Rab, of the Nitnifu Caleb and Mayim. The guy's shoes, his jacket, something gets ruined in the water. Who adds my potter? But if the person himself slips on the water, the guy who spilled the water is going to actually be exempt because karka oilam hazikasai. What's going to happen? The guy doesn't get injured from the water. He slips on the water and then he falls. He hits his head on something on the ground. That's not me, and therefore that guy's going to be potter. The Gemara does qualify, however, but the Tamamaya regarding what's the halacha if the water is already basically absorbed into the ground. Is how that's going to be different than if the water is still there. The next Mishnah discusses of Hamatznia Esakoitz. I mean, the second half of this Mishnah discusses the first Mishnah. If someone puts away a thorn or glass in the street, or if someone makes a wall out of thorns in the street, or if he has a wall that fell into the street and others get injured, so all these persons are going to be liable for that. So the Gemara qualifies that teaching too, and when you make the wool out of thorns, that you're liable, so that it's only b'mafriach, only if it's hovering over the street. But if, let's say, you made it exactly along your property line, then no, because people don't usually rub up against the wall, and that guy is mashuna. The next Mishnah continues regarding hamitzias tivnei b'kashal l'shus ram l'zvam. If someone takes out his straw or stubble to the street because people step on it, it makes it into fertilizer, and someone else gets injured, so he's going to be chayiv in the damages. The Gemara is going to say a chiddush in that, even when you'd be chayiv, and makolakod menzacha, whoever goes and grabs away your item, it's like hefker, you have no right to have it over there, and therefore they're going to be zaycha. But then there's a machlekes in the Gemara between Rav and Seiri regarding what's called konsu gufan mishum shevachan, meaning that the whatever is going to gain in being in the street, that they could go ahead and grab away. The question is, could they even take the principle, and do we penalize that because of shvach? But they both agree, davash im b'shvach lekonsu, if it does not have any shvach, then they did not penalize. You cannot grab away the principle itself. So begin the current daf lamed, second line down on the top of the amid, says the Mishnah Hashayvich Mayim B'Shus Harab. So someone pours again. This continued theme regarding making us obstacles, dangerous things in the street. Someone pours water in the street. V'Hozik Ben Acher. Someone else gets injured from that water. Chay Beniska, the guy who spilled the water, is liable for those damages. Halacha number two. Hamatznia, if someone hides as a kite, a thorn, or as a zchuch, as the glass, or another case, let's say he actually makes a wall out of thorns. Or case number three, or if he has a wall that collapsed and fell into the street, and others get injured. So that says the Mishnah, the one who this was his, he's liable for the damages of whoever got injured from these items. Now, the Gemara qualifies the opening halacha of the spilled water, which we already mentioned this, like we said in the Chav Chesem and Aleph. Amar Rav, he says, Loishon, we did not learn the halacha, the Reisha, about being liable for spilling water into the street. Someone else gets injured. Elo, the nitin fu Caleb amayim. When we said, Huzik ben Achar, what is the hezik that the other person had? Not his body. The hezik was on his car, let's say his clothing. His garments got ruined from the water. That's what the guy is going to be liable for. But if the guy himself got injured, Potter, the guy who spilled the water is going to be exempt. Why would that be? So the Rav explains, Karka Oilam Hazikasai. What injured the person? Was the ground. The water was only a grama, was only a causation. For that, I'm not liable if you get injured on the ground. However, on that, I'm going to Rav, I'm going to ask the Rav, Lo Yehei Elikadiv Shai. It should only be as much as, let's say, his mud, meaning, if someone throws fertilizer into the street, you don't think that the guy who threw the fertilizer is going to be liable when he's not mafgrit? Here also, it's his mud that injured that person because the water got mixed with the earth floor that there is on the street and became like a mud. And that's his. From the fact that we said that the garments got ruined in the mud, obviously that you were not mafkrit, because if it was a bar that were you a mafker, you wouldn't be chayiv on kalim. And Rav's qualifying that you begin be chayiv on his kalim, on his garments. So obviously you're not mafkrit. If you're not mafkrit, it means it was your mud that injured the guy who fell, because there's your water. So why are you saying karko elam hazikasa? It's your mud. Says the Gemara, no, mi sabrit, do you think that the loitamu maya, that the water was not yet used up, and rather it was gathered together and then made like mud, and therefore it's his ground? No, that's not the case at all. But the tamu maya, we're talking about that the water was depleted already, got absorbed, and there's no more mud, which Tosfos explains that if the water got absorbed, then stamma, the guy would have been mafkrit, and it should be bar, and you should be putter on kalim. So Tosfos explains, it wasn't totally absorbed, that as if it shouldn't have any utility whatsoever. It's just not enough to have made mud, and therefore, that's why the guy's going to be putter for the guy tripping and hitting his head on the ground, because it's not my ground, it's not my mud, there is no mud over here. There's a little water that you could slip on, a little water, but not enough to make a mud. That's how Tosfos explains it. And therefore, enough that you wouldn't have been mafkirid, and therefore you can be chayv on kalim because it's sure it's not bar. Okay. And that says the Gemara, retarti lamali. Well, why do you need two cases to tell us in the Mishnah, let's say in our Mishnah, Rav is qualifying that the Allah is only teen of kalim, only when the guy's garments get ruined. But we learned this in the Mishnah of Chav Ches and Aleph. The Mishnah of Chav Ches said, if someone's jug broke in the street and someone slipped on the water, which Rav also explained over there, on the Chav Ches and Beis, that it was talking about when you were not mafkrit, and it was talking about teen of kalim, and that the garments got ruined. So why do we need two Mishnahis to teach the same halacha? Says the Gemara, I'll tell you why. Because Chada, one of them is B'mayis HaChama, is in the summer months. B'chada, one of them is B'mayis HaGshamim, is in the winter months. And that, we have to tell you that even though you did it with permission in the winter months, that still, if it caused damage, you're going to have to pay the time, like Linda Brysa, that there's a chiddush over here in the winter months. Kaleilu sha'amru, all those things that the sages said, did you allow to make a ruin in the street? For example, they are piskin b'vaysehen. So you allow to empty out your wastewater pipes into the street, which all the utility you had in the house, all the dirty water, you allow to open those out, up those pipes. For Gerfin, what I'm saying, they could shovel out all their caves with the porta potties, all those things. You let us spill it out. So all those things, b'maisa chama, in the summer months, in Lamrishus, they have no permission to spill out the street, because in the summer, the streets are nice and clean. And I just read a story last night from, I think, Baruch Beth. They asked him, how was America? He says, this is an amazing country, because even the streets were clean. You're able to think and learning, as you, wherever you are. We're saying, Kamenetz, this is the filth everywhere. You couldn't learn in the streets. So I'm saying, in the summer months, things are clean. You have no rishus to spill things out. But in the winter months, yeshlem rishus. Anyways, the streets are dirty and filthy, the rain and the snow and whatever, so you have permission. Now, that the chiddush in our mission is, even though it was permission, that's what our mission is teaching you, the chiddush. Although we already had this nav chavches, but if they cause damage, they're going to have to pay. So that's the chiddush of our mission. But again, it's the same halacha of nitnufu kelov, but it's not regarding the person, because the person would be just a grumma and be put. The second half of the Mishnah said, Hametznias akleitz. If someone went and put away a thorn, b'chulu, or glass, or he built a fence of thorns between his property, so then we said that you're going to be chayiv. Now, regarding that middle case of agoides gidre b'kleitzim, so Amar B'yechon, and he qualifies this, and we already mentioned this also in the previous daf, Lo'ishan, we didn't learn this halacha, ele mafriach, only if this You didn't get the gardener to go ahead and cut that thorn bush. It's hovering over the street, and someone got injured. But if it was precise into your property, then you're not liable. So my time apart, why are you exempt? So Amravachabreidaviki says Lafisha in Darkon Shabani Adam, it's not normal for people as Chachebriksam to rub up against walls. You gotta know the guy has real sensory issues if he's rubbing against walls when he's walking in the street. It's not your liability. And therefore, if it gets injured from your thorn bush wool, you're going to be exempt. A later discussion, talking about within the Braisa, a mitznia kvatsaisav, if someone puts away his thorns or his chliyosav or his glass, l'tech kaisel shel chaveiro, into his friend's wool. Now, above al kaisel, now the owner of the wall comes, v'sosel kaisel, he knocks down his wall. Now, the stones obviously seemed like that was not going to be a problem, that people got injured. But what happened was the glass that was there, that was all the thorns that were inside the wall, that went behizik and that damaged other people. So the halacha is chayiv ha-metznia. So the one who put away the glass or the thorn, he's liable for the damages. That's what the Braisa says. On that, Rabbi Yochanan says, Loishon, we didn't learn this teaching, el b'kozlu ru'ua, only by a shaky wall. So what's a shaky wall? The one who put it there should have entertained the thought that this wall was going to be knocked down and this is going to happen. There's going to be in the street and someone's going to get injured. But if it's a strong wall, I'm a tznia potter. So the guy who put it there is exempt because there's no reason why he should have entertained to say that this is going to cause damage. And the owner of the wall is going to be liable because he should have entertained the idea that people are going to put thorns in his wall. So he should have gone and hid it. It's the liability is on the owner of the wall. That's Rashi Davalilat's Ne'inu. I don't know what he means exactly, but he should have hidden whatever thorns of whoever's it is in his wall. Now Amar Ravina, he says that Zoyse Meres, this tells us, Hamachasa Boiroi Bedolyoi. If someone goes and covers his pit with the covering of a pit shel chaveri of his friend, so he takes someone else's cover to cover his pit, and then the owner of the pitcher comes and takes away his pitcher to cover the pit. He takes away the cover. Chayv balabar, the owner of the pit is liable because this is essentially what we said regarding the guy who put the thorns, which the thorns are a bur. And we said he put that bur in the shaky wall of his friend. This guy knocked down his wall, which who are we holding liable? Not the guy who knocked down the wall. By a strong wall, we'll hold him liable. He's like, he's making the bur. But being mechayv de matznia, he should have entertained that the guy's going to take his bucket. He's saying it's the same idea. You should have entertained to say that your bur is going to cause damage because the guy's going to take away the cover. The guy's going to knock down the shaky wall. So Gemara says, Pshita, this is obvious. Well, what's Rabbi actually coming to tell us? There seems to be an exact outgrowth of that halacha. So that says, Gemara, no matter what you say, it's not comparable because Hasam, who over there, the reason why there's no liability to the owner of the wall, Glaviyadale. He didn't know for the guy who put it to Loidoi. I mean, he didn't know who put it there, that he should notify him to take his thorns. And the Bach adds on the words, now regarding the strong wall, the reason why we hold the owner of the wall as liable is because he did something that he changed things, that he knocked down the strong wall. So again, that's his fault. Fine. But by the shaky wall, the reason why we would say that he's going to be exempt is because it's not his fault. It's a shaky wall, and I don't know who put the thorns over there. So therefore, the guy who put the thorns will be liable, but I don't know who it is to let him know. But over here, when you have the owner of the pitcher, the yadale, the owner of the pit knows whose pitcher it is. He should have notified him that he's taking away his pitcher, and then to go ahead and hold him liable. Kamash Malan, that's what Rav has come to teach us, that no, that's not the reason. And therefore, the owner of the pitcher is going to be exempt because the owner of the pitch should have realized this idea. So therefore, you might have thought to say that they're different because one of them you could notify and one you can't. And that's even so, that's not the point. The point is regarding should you have entertained to say that this is going to be a bur, either because someone's going to take away his cover or because it's going to knock down the shaky wall. And that's the primary criterion for your liability. Now the Gemara concludes a related idea to this about putting away your thorns and your glass. Seems like that they didn't know what to do with it. The earlier pious ones, that they would hide away their thorns and their glass, but they're the same in their fields. They would dig deep down three hand breaths, and the reason was kadishlei akav amachrisha, so that it should not hold back the plowing. This brings in the Yashami. so that it doesn't come up with the plowing. But be that as it may, I want it to be deep, deep, deep down that it doesn't get in the way of anyone getting injured or stopping the plowing. Rav Sheshes, he shud the lubenuda, he would throw it into the fire. So that would be a good way of getting rid of it. And Rav shud lubediglas, he would throw it into the Tigris, into the chidekel, into the river. Now, a related teaching regarding being a chassid, as we said, these chassidim or shayinim, so the well-known teaching regarding learning such a masech like Baba Kama, Baba Metzia, Baba Basra, the masech is of Nizikin. So Rav Yehuda, he says, "Hai man de boil me bechassida. Whoever wants to be a chassid, a pious one, lekayim mili de nizakin, should fulfill the teachings of nizakin, which are these masechtas of damages. A person becomes a person of chesed, of chassid, of someone that understands the interpersonal relationships of learning nizakin. Rav Ami says mil de avos. You should fulfill the teachings of masechtas avos. Rav Ami, some say mil de brachas. The teaching masechta brachas, which is well known, Marsha, Maral, they all say." But these are the three types of relationships that we have. There's Ben Adam La'atzmoy, Ben Adam La'mokim, Ben Adam La'chaveroy, that's Torah V'Digimas Chasadim. Those are the three things. Mili, the Avos is Ben Adam La'atzmoy, Mil de Brachis, Ben Adam La'mokim, and Mili de Nizakin is Ben Adam La'chaveroy. These three are with this really what it means to be chesed or chesed. It means going, expanding yourself into another dimension. There's three ways of doing that. Those are the three dimensions of relationships. We can take a look at the next Mishnah of this theme about the street, about putting things in the street causing problems. So, Amitzias Tivne Bekashal Leshusram. Someone takes out his straw, his stubble into the street, Lizavalim. What do you mean, Lizavalim? He wants that his straw and his stubble should decompose, compost, and become like fertilizer to fertilize the fields and the vineyards. Now, Huzik Ben Acher, someone else gets injured on his compost that he's doing, this is naturalist that puts it onto the street, and someone gets injured on that. So says the Tanna Kamma, Chai ben Niskai, so he's liable for his damage. Whoever comes first could grab away this guy's compost, the guys could take it, his fertilizer, and take it home. Shemulilam, he says, all destructive things in the street and they cause damage, the owner is liable to pay. And whoever comes first could take it away. Which, as Rashi points out, the Rishon Leil understood from the Tanna Kamma that he only penalizes the shevach, the what it became better in the street, but the principle you cannot take, as the Brisa teaches in the Gemara. Rishon Leil comes to tell us that no, even the principle itself, whoever comes first could take it out. Or another interpretation that he was saying, the words kol makalkalin is even if the guy did it with rishus, but still, since it's makalkal, since it causes destruction, you're allowed to take it. The last halacha of the Mishnah says, "Halifech hasagol b'shusram," which we already discussed this teaching on the Chavtes Mabez. Someone turns over the fertilizer that's there in the street, the animal dung, vuzi benachas. Someone gets injured from it. Chayiv beniska, the guy who did the hipuch, the guy who turned it over, is going to be liable for those damages. Says the Gemara, "Limasin d'lekabi." Let's say our Mishnah is not like a Behuda. Why? Kaitan l'in the brayser. He says, "B'shas haitzas zavalim." At the time of the taking out of the manure, adam mitzi zavala l'rishus harabim. A person could take out his fertilizer to the street, but zavare kol shleishim b'yom, he could pile it up over there for all the 30 days that he's allowed to leave it over there. They say nishrif b'dagli adam rag b'hem, that it should be stepped on by people's feet and animals' feet, because shamanas ken hichal Yeshua sagetz. It's with that intention that Yeshua ben Nun bequeathed the land of Israel to the Jewish people, that people shouldn't be particular about that. So you see, you're allowed to do this, so why are we saying that the person is going to be liable and whoever wants can grab it away? Says Gemara, no. I felt that maybe you could say the Mishnah is a Yehudah. That if it damages, you got to pay what the damage is. But then Taisa says, wait a second, but the Mishnah said, how could you say that whoever wants can take it if you have permission to do that? Taisa says, after 30 days, and if you didn't take it away, then the guys could take it. But before 30 days, they cannot take it. But yes, you can be liable, whatever damage is going to be. Says Gemara, but how could you say our mission is Rabbi Huda? But now we learn the mission of Samach Beis, Samach Beis. Says Rabbi Huda Omer, who this is, we're discussing the town of Rabbi Huda. He says, B'ner Chanukah, Potter, this is in Perek HaKoinis, which the Mishnah teaches over there regarding the case of the camel that was laden with flax. So we say that if the owner had a candle outside, it's his fault that the camel, his straw got lit up. And but if, let's say, it was Ner Chanukah, he's exempt nishu birshus, because you have permission to put your Ner Chanukah outside in the street. Ooh, my love isn't telling me mishum birshus bezin, because the courts give you permission to put it on the outside, because the presumini is to publicize the miracle, so you're going to be putter. So you see that when you have birshus, you're not liable. How could you say the time the Mishnah is Rabbi Huda, who says you're allowed to put it out into the street, but if it's damaging Michayev, don't you see from the loch of Ner Chanukah that you're going to be putter if you have permission to do something? No, Ner Chanukah is different. Ner Chanukah is Mishum Rishus Mitzvah. That's the permission of a mitzvah. In other words, because the courts give you permission to perform a mitzvah, then you're putter. But just in general, if the courts give you permission to do something volitional, that's not a mitzvah. No, then you would be chayiv. The time like Luna Brisa. He says, "B'nei Chanukah potter." The reason why you're potter by Ner Chanukah, in Yonder Diyama, there's a Rishus Mitzvah, because it's a permission of a mitzvah, and therefore, even if damages happen, you're going to be potter. But it could be just a regular Rishus of Bezdin, you would be chayiv. Says Gemara, okay, Tashma, I'll try to bring another ride from a Brisa. The Brisa says, "Kol Elu Sha'amru," all these things that they said, "Mutarin LeKalkel B'Rishus Rabim," that you're allowed to cause things that are making filth and destruction in the street. For example, let's say emptying out your sewer pipes and all the different from your sewer system into the street. In Mezikui, if they cause damage, says the town, the Kamachayim Lashamo, okay, but you're still liable to pay. Rabbi Yehuda Pait, Rabbi Yehuda says you're exempt. So you see clearly that he's not like the town of our Mishnah, which says that you're going to be chayiv. So Rav Nachman says, no, it's not true. It could still be like Rabbi Yehuda. How so? Because Masnit and Shalib Shasat Zvalim. Our mission is talking not at a time when people usually take out their waste, their garbage. Rabbi Yehuda, and therefore it could even be like Rabbi Yehuda. When Rabbi Yehuda say that you're going to be potter is when it's shasat zavalim. When it's not those times, then you're going to be chayv. Or another approach of Ashi, I mean, he says as it continued to Amud Beis, is that tavnoi bikashe tanan. In our Mishnah that we're saying that you're going to be chayiv, is specifically as we spoke about your straw and your stubble, where they did not become fertilizer yet, and they're still hard. Mishum de misriki, because they cause people to slip. When you would say you're going to be potter is by fertilizer, where a person takes out fertilizer, it's not so easy to slip on. That's something that you would not be chayiv, and therefore it's not a kastira. Could be he holds, like the town of a Mishnah, you'd be chayiv when it's still kash b'tavit. Now the Mishnah said, not only that is the guy chayiv, but we said, kolakoyd men zacha. Whoever grabs it away first, you come with your U-Haul and you take away, you haul away this guy's fertilizer, you could be zeichin. Now, as a machleik is in the Gemara, how to qualify this teaching. Amar Rav, he says, Bein begufon, bein b'shvachan. This is whether the principle itself that's becoming fertilizer, or even what it got better in the street, both of them. Zichum says, no, b'shivchan, only what it got better in the street, that it were penalizing. Aval lebegufim, but not the principle itself. Says Yom Ha'Mikvah, what's machlekes? Or Avsavi holds concept gufim mishum shvachan. You're right. Really, it's the shvach itself that we penalize, because that's the iser. The iser was not on the principle. The iser was on what is getting better by being here in the street. But we penalize the principle because of the shvach. Zidusavi says no, like concept gufim mishum shvachan. We didn't penalize the principle because of the shvach. Now the Gemara, however, asks on Rav from our Mishnah itself. The last case Tanan, we learned, if someone turns over the animal dung in the street, now you flipped it over, someone else gets injured in it, so chayiv b'niska. We said, okay, you're liable for the damages. Wait a second. The ilu, whereas this case of kol hakodem zacha, to say that whoever comes first will be zeicha, loy katoni. It doesn't say that. Why? Because gull is rei, is the waste matter. And that doesn't get better into the street. It already is fertilizer. It's not like straw that when it decomposes, it becomes like waste matter. This is it's decomposed in the animal's stomach. So it's already mishubach, and it's like that. So that's difficult on Rav, because Rav said that we don't penalize only shvach, we penalize guf also. If that's the case, you should be able to take away, haul away the waste matter to the fertilizer. Says the Gemara, you're right. But Tanul Reisha, we don't have to repeat it two times. We already said in the Reisha, Kanzu Guf Mishim Shvachan. The same thing applies by the Sefer. We're just not saying it. Says, well, you can't say that. Because Matani Allah, we had a Brisa on this part of the Mishnah that says, Asurin Mishim Gezel. It actually is forbidden because of Gezel. So you see clearly that we're not penalized the principle. Says the Gemara, no. But Ki Katani, when did we say Asurin Mishim Gezel? That it's forbidden because of theft. Akula Masnitin Koi. It's going on the whole Mishnah, even on Tevin and Kash. So therefore, you know what it must be saying? It must be saying Loiser Shekadim Mezacha. The guy who came first and jumped on the pile and he did Agvah, we're saying now someone else cannot steal it from him. That's interesting interpretation that the Gemara attempts right now, but the Gemara anyway says it's not really true because, well, like Tanya, we didn't learn like this. There's none, which actually a Bryce that says, if someone takes out his straw and his stubble to the street to make it into fertilizer, someone else gets injured, Chayv ben Iski is liable for his damages. Whoever comes first merits it. And there's no problem by gazel. So you see that differentiating there, there's no asur mishum gazel. But if you turned over, you flipped over the gull in Rosh Hashanah, someone else gets injured, Chayv, it is liable, but asur mishum gazel. So obviously it's differentiating. You can't say like the way Rob answered that Asur Mishum Gezel is going the whole mission and it's 2 months. If a guy was Zoich already, then the next guy after him would be liable for stealing from him. So Amar Rav Nachman Yitzchok, he says a different answer. He says, Gol Karamis, you ask him in the case of Gol, why according to Rab, the whole you penalize not only Shlach, but also the Guf, the principle, why here cannot a guy just haul it off and take it for himself? Davar Sheyesh B'Shvach, no, there's a difference. Something that could have benefit, that could get better. That's where Kanto Guv Mishum Shvacha, like by Gol, like by Kash V'Tevin, the straw, it's the husk of the stalk of the wheat. But when you let it sit there, it could ferment and fertilize, and then you're going to penalize the principal because of what it got better in the street, and the guy could haul away the whole thing. But Davashim Mishvach, like Gol is not getting any better. It already is the gold that it is. Like Hunter, there they didn't penalize. It's only Mishum Shvachan, but if it doesn't have Shvachan, then you're right, we didn't penalize the Guv itself, and if it's not difficult, on Rav. Now, Ibailu had the following question. L'divrei ha'omer, according to the one who holds, meaning Rav, that comes to Guv and Mishum Shvachan, that we penalize the principal because of what it gets better, la'alta kansinan, do we penalize it right away? Meaning that the moment the guy puts out his straw and the stubble, you could go and haul it off? L'chimaisi Shvachan kansinan, maybe it's only when it gets better, it turns into fertilizer. Then you could haul off his straw with that also. But it's only when you're only gonna have the kanzu guf mishvach when the shvach is there. So the Gemara says tashma, it's being a raya mitkayin and gol. As Rashi explains, from the fact that we had used the case of gol to ask on Rav, the inference is that he held that we penalize right away, because if it's only one to bring shvach, what's the question from gol? But there is no shvach but gol. So how could you even ask to say that to haul away the principle of the gull, but I thought even when you do penalize the principles, only when the shvach is there. Obviously that no, we penalize the goof right away. So the Gemara says, what are you talking about? Is your question even logical? Kiyadin the gull, when we had asked the question from gull, was mekmeid the lashon of Nachman, who was before Rav Nachman gave his answer that we thought that even though it's not going to end up bringing shvach, we thought maybe Rav would penalize. For sure, something that's going to have shvach, of course we thought then that you penalize right away. Of course, that's inherent. But Rabbos Lashon Rav Nachman, which is where we're at right now, after Rav Nachman gave his answer, Mikal Mimri Gol Klal, you think you could ask from Gol at all? Because now that we understand that the whole reason why we penalize the principle is only because of the shvach, so now we could ask, is that immediate or it's only when they bring shvach? So it's not a riot from the question we ask. That question was totally off. Of course that was inherent over there, but we're not with that principle anymore. So that's not going to answer our question. Says Gemara, let me get tanoi. Let's say it's a machligis tanoi. We have a brice that says as follows: Shtar shekasuv boy. If you have a document that's written on it that the guy borrowed with ribis, with forbidden interest, so the loch is like this. Kainzin isai, so they penalize him, and the ina goyvi is not allowed to collect. Loyas a karen, the loyas a ribis dibri mayor. The guy cannot collect now, not the principal, and not the interest according to a man. Chamam, the sages say no. Goyvis a karen, the guy could collect the principal that he had lent the guy. A loyas a ribis, but not the forbidden interest. Says the Gemara, lema. Let's say Rav damakre mayor ziva damakre banan. It seems like that Rav, who says that you penalize not only the shevach, the interest, but also the principal, is like Remeir, who says you penalize everything. And Ze'iri, who says only the shevach are we penalizing, is like the Rabban, who says we're only going to penalize the forbidden interest, but not the principal. So I'm like a Rab would tell you, no. Another Amri, I could even tell you that the Afil Rabban. I could even be like the Rabban. Why? Ad can come Rabban Hassan. Where do we find the Rabban over there that they don't penalize the principal? Because really the principal is permitted. You're allowed to lend someone money to get back the same amount of money. So therefore, we're not penalizing that. But here, the Karen, it's the principal itself, is going to damage when it turns into the fertilizer, or even now as straw, you could slip on it. So therefore, that's why it's going to be different. He would tell you, no, I could even be like a mayor, that even though there he penalizes the principal also, because when you write the document of the loan, the avod lay suma, meaning he already placed on him this neshach, and he violated what it says in the Torah in Shemesh Chabez, loisoy simun. Don't go and place this loan with interest. So therefore, that includes also the whole loan, which is the principal too. Who said it's going to damage? And therefore, there's nothing wrong with the principal itself. And therefore, it could be that he would agree to me that here you would not penalize the principal. Okay, so let's say it's like the following tanoi. The Braisa says, someone takes out his straw, his stubble to the street for fertilizer, and someone else gets injured. The halacha is, he's liable for his damages. And whoever comes first can take away this guy's stuff. And it's forbidden because of theft, which the Gemara is going to jump on, obviously, in 1 second. He says, all destructive things in the street that cause damage, you have to pay for. Whoever comes first can take it. And it's permitted. There's no problem for theft. It says the Gemara, hugufu kasha. You have a difficulty over here. Amrit, the Tanakhama said, kolokoid men zacha, whoever comes first can merit it. Brother Kama, then you say, Asur Mishim Gezel, it's forbidden for theft. What do you mean? You say you could take it. What do you mean you're saying forbidden for theft? Oh, Elav Achakama, rather must be what the Tanakhama is saying like this. Kolokoid behen, whoever comes first, zacha b'shivchan. He can merit in the Shevach and what it improved. But Vasur Mishim Gezel, agufan. This is saying you're not allowed to steal it. It's going on the principle itself. Ah, that's what Rishim Lila was coming to say. No, even the principle itself, whoever comes first can merit, and therefore he says Mutar Rishim Gazel, because he's going in the principle. So seemingly the Machleik is the Rav, and Ziri is the Machleik is Tanoim in this Braisa. Says the Gemara, so the Gemara concludes, no, L'Ziri Vada Tanoi. You're right, according to Ziri, you have to say Machleik is Tanoim, because he can't say that according to everyone, you don't penalize the principal, because Reb Shimon clearly penalizes the principal too. So that can't be. But the Rav says, do we have to say according to Rav, it's a machlokes tanoi? Says the Amalcha Rav, no. The Kulam, he can tell you that everyone holds, comes to Guf Mishim Shavachan, that you do penalize the principal because of the praise. So then what does the Tanakhama mean that Asur Mishim Gezel? You're right, he really did say also Kolagad Nezalcha. So it would sound like that you're allowed to take everything. But he said Asur Mishim Gezel. What's Asur Mishim Gezel? So the machlik is regarding if you have a halacha, but you're not supposed to instruct people. Tanakhama held that this halacha that we penalize the principal is what's called in meirin king. And that is, you're right, the halacha is kolokod men zacha. And even the principal, b'di'eved, that if a guy takes it, he could keep it. But if he comes to us and he asks the Rav and he says, what's, you know, the halacha, is it? Asur Mishum Gazel. It's forbidden because of theft. Because it's what's called halacha ve'in meirinkin. We don't instruct people to take it. Whereas, according to Reb Shimon, he held, yes, meirinkin, and therefore it's mutarad in Mishum Gazel, like we learned. Vuna Merabi says halacha ve'in meirinkin. It's halacha, but we do not instruct. Ravad Rahaba Omei says halacha meirinkin. He says halacha, and that we instruct. Says the Gemara that, Ini, is that really so? That the question is specifically on Rav Huna. Rav Huna said that it's ein meirin, that we do not instruct. But the Gemara brings forward Rav Huna, afke chushli. There were these peeled barley that someone had spread out in the street so that they should dry. And Rav Huna was mafkrit, and he instructed whoever wants could take it. So to Rav Adrahava, he was afke as gittin tab of laman alf, salikusta, which are these, the waste matter of the pressed dates that you made beer out of, or it's the sediments of the date beer, which they would dry up the sediments like congealed wine, and they would give it to the donkeys to eat. But be that as it may, the Gemara concludes and says, Bish lema rabad bra'avo kishmaite, he's going like his teaching that he said, halacha umayrin kein. that it's halacha and you instruct. So therefore he says, yeah, we follow, we tell people, you can take the principle. But El Rav Huna, but Rav Huna who said that halacha ve'ein moirin kein, le'mahadabe, shall we say that he retracted? Because how did he say that everyone could take it? I thought that you don't instruct people. You say asur mishem gezel. Says Gemara hanu musrin hava. These individuals were warned many times and to remove their stuff and they didn't remove it. So like the signs in the coat room say, after December 1st, all coats will be hefker. And that's the same thing. Is that although we're not moirin kein, but they warned, they didn't listen. That's why he was mafkid. But really, generally, he was hold regarding this halacha of the principle that you're not supposed to have into the street, that we're going to penalize only the shvach, but the principle itself, we will be ein moirin kein. Thank you to any time.